Dear students, today let's solve problems of differentiation level 2. Let's look at the first question. First question is actually the second question. Question number 2. If f of 2 is equal to 4 and f dash of 2 is equal to 1, then limit extends to 2 x f of x minus 2 f of x divided by x minus 2 is equal to 1. See here, we have limit extends to 2 x into f of x minus 2 into f of x divided by x minus 2. Directly if I apply the limit as extends to 2, I am getting 2 into f of 2 minus 2 into f of 2. So numerator is 0. Denominator 2 minus 2, that is also 0. 0 by 0, this is an indeterminate form. Okay. So now I can go for L-Hospital's rule. So L-Hospital's rule, if I use limit extends to 2, product rule I have to use here, x into derivative f of x, which is f dash of x, plus f of x into derivative of x, that is 1, minus 2 into the derivative f of x, which is f dash of x, divided by the derivative of x minus 2, that is 1. Now I apply the limit as extends to 2. So this will give you 2 into f dash of 2 plus f of 2 minus 2 into f dash of 2 divided by 1. Okay, that will give you 2 f dash of 2 gets cancelled. This is equal to f of 2. What's the value of f of 2? Given that f of 2 is 4, that's the answer. 4, which is the third option. Next question. Question number 3. If y is equal to 1 by root of x square plus 4 plus root of x square plus 2, then dy by dx is equal to y is equal to 1 by root of x square plus 4 plus root of x square plus 2. I will rationalize the denominator, that is, I am multiplying and dividing by root of x square plus 4 minus root x square plus 2. So that will give you 1 by root x square plus 4 plus root x square plus 2 into, I am multiplying and dividing by root of x square plus 4 minus root of x square plus 2. So now numerator will be root x square plus 4 minus root x square plus 2. What about denominator? Denominator is of the form a plus b into a minus b, that will give you a square minus b square, which means x square plus 4 minus of x square plus 2. X square plus 4 minus of x square plus 2. X square gets cancelled. 4 minus 2 will give you 2. This is our y. Now y dash, that's equal to 1 by 2 into, take that 2 out, 1 by 2 into, derivative of root x square plus 4. Derivative of root x square plus 4 is 1 by 2 root of x square plus 4 into 2x minus 1 by 2 root x square plus 2 into 2x. Okay, now 2, 2 gets cancelled. Take that x as a common factor here. Then we will get y dash is equal to, I will write here because not enough space is available. Y dash is equal to x by 2 into 1 by root of x square plus 4 minus 1 by root of x square plus 2. 1 x by 2 into 1 by root x square plus 4 minus 1 by root x square plus 2, which is the first option. Okay, then fifth question. Dy by dx of e power n log a plus x minus log a minus x is equal. Okay, I'll call that as y. Let y is equal to e to the power n into, look here, we have n into log a plus x minus log a minus x. It's of the form log m minus log n. Log m minus log n can be written as log m by n. So that will give you log of a plus x by a minus x. Okay? Log m minus log n is equal to log m by n. Then n log a plus x by a minus x. We can write this as e to the power log a plus x by a minus x whole power n. N log m is nothing but log m power n. Okay? Now e power log f of x. E power log f of x is nothing but f of x. So we get y is equal to a plus x by a minus x whole power n. Let us differentiate this now. Y dash is equal to n into a plus x by a minus x whole power n minus 1 into the derivative of a plus x by a minus x. A plus x by a minus x, I'll write as x plus a divided by minus x plus a plus x by a minus x. Right? This is of the form ax plus b divided by cx plus d. Derivative of ax plus b by cx plus d is equal to ad minus bc divided by cx plus d whole square. So using that formula, we can write the derivative as a plus a, that means 2a divided by minus x plus a whole square. Or I can write a minus x whole square. That's equal to 2a into n into a plus x whole power n minus 1 divided by a minus x whole power n plus 1. Because here you have a minus x whole power n minus 1 into this a minus x whole square. So altogether it will become a minus x whole power n plus 1. So 2an into a plus x whole power n minus 1 divided by a minus x whole power n plus 1, which is the third option. Third option is the right answer. Then, sixth question. If y is equal to e power sin square x plus sin power 4x plus sin power 6x etc. till infinity, then what is dy by dx? Okay. Y is equal to e to the power sin square x plus sin power 4x plus sin power 6x and so on up to infinity. Now look at this power, sin square x plus sin power 4x plus sin power 6x and so on till infinity. It is in GP. What is the first term of this GP? The first term is sin square x. And what's the common ratio? Common ratio is also sin square x. You know the formula for sum to infinity of a GP. Sum to infinity of a GP is given by a by 1 minus r. So y is equal to e to the power a by 1 minus r, a is sin square x, divided by 1 minus r, r is also sin square x. So 1 minus sin square x, I'll write it as cos square x, then e power sin square x by cos square x will be tan square x. So we have e power tan square x, this is y. Let's differentiate this, y dash is equal to e to the power tan square x into, now the derivative of tan square x, derivative of tan square x is 2 tan x into secant square x. So e power tan square x into 2 tan x into secant square x, which is the third option. Then, question 7. If mod x is less than 1, then derivative of 1 plus p by q whole power x plus p by q into x plus p into p plus q by 2 factorial into x by q whole square plus p into p plus q into p plus 2 q by 3 factorial into x by q whole cube etc. up to infinity is equal. See, you have studied this in binomial theorem. This expression, it is the expansion of 1 minus x whole power minus p by q. The expansion of 1 minus x whole power minus p by q is 1 plus p by q into x plus p into p plus q by 2 factorial into x by q whole square and so on. This expansion. It is the expansion of 1 minus x whole power minus p by q. So I call this as y. Then y is equal to this 1 minus x whole power minus p by q. Now differentiate this. Y dash is equal to x of the form x power n, derivative of this is minus p by q into 1 minus x to the power minus p by q minus 1 into the derivative of 1 minus x. Derivative of 1 minus x is minus 1. So y dash is equal to minus p by q into minus p by q plus p by q. P divided by q into, I take the denominator, it will become 1 minus x to the power p by q plus 1. P by q into 1 by 1 minus x to the power p by q plus 1, which means first option is the right answer. Then question 9. D by dx of 3 power minus 5 by 3 log of 2x plus 1 to the base 3 is equal to 3 to the power minus 5 by 3. I'll call this as y. Then y equal to 3 power minus 5 by 3 log 2x plus 1 to the base 3. Okay? Now, this is of the form n log m. N log m is equal to log m power n. So, we will write this as 3 power log of 2x plus 1 to the power minus 5 by 3 to the base 3. Okay. Here, I use one property. A power log b to the base a is equal to b. A to the power log b to the base a is equal to b. This is one of the properties of logarithms. A to the power log b to the base a is equal to b. So by using that formula, we can write this expression as 2x plus 1 to the power minus 5 by 3. 2x plus 1 to the power minus 5 by 3. Now let us differentiate this. Y dash is equal to minus 5 by 3 into 2x plus 1 to the power minus 5 by 3 minus 1. Minus 5 by 3 minus 1, that will give you minus 8 by 3 into the derivative of 2x plus 1, which is 2. So y dash is equal to minus 10 by 3 into 2x plus 1 to the power minus 8 by 3. We can take this 2x plus 1 to the power minus 8 by 3 to the denominator. When it goes to the denominator, it will become 2x plus 1 to the power 8 by 3. That means we will get minus 10 divided by 3 into 2x plus 1 to the power 8 by 3. Minus 10 by 3 into 2x plus 1 to the power 8 by 3, which is the first option. Then, 10th question. If h of x is equal to e power x, then h dash of x divided by h of x is equal to h dash of x by h of x equal to what? That's the question. Okay. So they have given that h of x is equal to e to the power x. Okay? I'll take log on both sides. Taking log on both sides, that will give you log h of x is equal to log e to the power x, which means log h of x is equal to log of e power x is nothing but e power x itself. Log h of x, log of e power x, we write this as e power x into log e. Log e is 1, so e power x into 1 will give you e power x. Now let us differentiate this. Differentiating this with respect to x. Derivative of log h of x is 1 by h of x into h dash of x. That's equal to. Derivative of e power x is. So h dash of x divided by h of x is equal to e power x. That's the answer. But unfortunately, e power x is not there in the options. But what is e power x? Observe here, e power x can be replaced by log h of x, which means h dash of x by h of x is equal to log h of x. So, third option is the right answer. This is one way of solving this problem. Some of you may be thinking, sir, why should I take log? If I don't take log, can I not solve this problem? Yes, you can solve this problem without taking log also. I'll explain how. You can directly differentiate and find out h dash of x by h of x. There, from there also you will get this answer. Let us see how. Differentiating this with respect to x. Derivative of this is h dash of x is equal to derivative of e power x is e power x into the derivative of e power x. Derivative of e power x is e power x. Okay? Now, we are asked to find out h dash of x divided by h of x. This expression divided by this expression. So, when I divide it, that e power x gets cancelled. What will remain then? E power x will remain. Okay? E, h dash of x by h of x is equal to e power x. But option does not contain that. Verify the options. First option, is it equal to h of x? No, because h of x is e power x. So, that's not the right answer. 1 by h of x. 1 by h of x will be 1 by e power x. That's not equal to e power x. Then log h of x. What is log h of x? Take log here. You will get log h of x as log h of x is equal to log e power x. You can write this as e power x into log e. Log e is 1. So that's equal to e power x. E power x can be replaced by log h of x. Which means third option is the correct answer. Okay, 12th question. If y is equal to sine inverse of root of x minus a divided by b minus a, where x is between a and b, then dy by dx is equal to. Y is equal to sine inverse of square root of x minus a by b minus a. Okay, y dash is equal to. If the derivative of sine inverse x we know, which is equal to 1 by root 1 minus x square. Now we are asked to find the derivative of sine inverse of root of x minus a by b minus a. In place of x, we have root of x minus a by b minus a. So y dash is equal to 1 by root of 1 minus x square. 1 by root of 1 minus x square. X square, that is x minus a by b minus a. Into, now I have to write the derivative of root of x minus a by b minus a. That is 1 by 2 into root of x minus a by b minus a into, now the derivative of x minus a by b minus a. Here b minus a is a constant, so 1 by b minus a you can keep as it is. Derivative of x minus a is 1. So 1 by b minus a. Okay, what next? Y dash is equal to 1 by, I will take LCM here, LCM is b minus a. This on simplification will give you root of b minus a minus of x minus a. B minus a minus of x minus a means minus a plus a gets cancelled. You will have b minus x divided by b minus a into 1 by 2 root of x minus a by b minus a into 1 by b minus a. Look here. Here you have root b minus a, here you have another root b minus a. Root b minus a into root b minus a will give you b minus a. That b minus a gets cancelled with this b minus a. So at the end, after all the simplification, you will be left with 1 by 2 into root of b minus x into x minus a. 1 by 2 into root of b minus x into x minus a, which is the second option. Then, 13th question. If a square minus, if root of a square minus x square plus root of a square minus y square is equal to k into x minus y, then what is dy by dx? Direct differentiation will take a bit more time. So, let's make some substitution here. Root of a square minus x square plus root of a square minus y square is equal to k into x minus y. This is what we have. I will make a substitution as put x equal to a sin theta and y is equal to a sin phi. Okay? In place of x, I am substituting a sin theta and in place of y, I will substitute a sin phi. Then, theta will be equal to sin theta is equal to x by a, so theta is sin inverse of x by a. Sin phi is equal to y by a, which means phi is equal to sin inverse of y by a. Okay. Here, a square minus x square. X is a sin theta, x square will be a square sin square theta. Taking a square common, a square into 1 minus sin square theta, you get a square cos square theta. Root of a square cos square theta. On the same lines, this will become a square cos square phi. What happens on RHS? a into x minus y. X is a sin theta minus y, which is a sin phi. Here this will be a cos theta plus a cos phi. Here I will take a as common. A k into sin theta minus sin phi. So that a gets cancelled. Then we are left with cos theta plus cos phi is equal to k into sin theta minus sin phi. We will be left with this much. Now I will use the formula cos c plus cos d. What is cos c plus cos d? Cos c plus cos d is equal to 2 cos c plus d by 2 into cos c minus d by 2 is equal to. On RHS we have k into sin theta minus sin phi. Here I will use sin c minus sin d formula. Sin c minus sin d is equal to 2 cos c plus d by 2, that is theta plus phi by 2, into sin c minus d by 2, sin of theta minus phi by 2. Okay, so 2 gets cancelled, cos theta plus phi by 2 gets cancelled. Here you have cos theta minus phi by 2 is equal to k into sin theta minus phi by 2. Break that sin theta minus phi by 2 to LHS. So after simplification you have got theta minus phi by 2 is equal to k. So theta minus phi by 2 is equal to cot inverse k. Theta minus phi is equal to 2 cot inverse k. What is theta and what is phi? You substitute that. Theta is nothing but sine inverse of x by a. Phi is sine inverse of y by a. That's equal to 2 cot inverse k. Now differentiate this. Derivative of sin inverse of x by a is 1 by root of 1 minus x square by a square into 1 by a minus derivative of sin inverse of y by a is 1 by root of 1 minus y square by a square into 1 by a into y dash. On RHS we have a constant whose derivative is 0. K is a constant, therefore cot inverse k is a constant, and hence 2 into cot inverse k is also a constant, so its derivative is 0. Okay, so now here let us simplify. Root of a square minus x square by a square. When that a square comes outside this root, it becomes a. This a gets cancelled. Similarly, here also a gets cancelled. So finally, we are left with 1 by root of a square minus x square minus 1 by root of a square minus y square into y dash is equal to 0. Take this to RHS, sir. So y dash will be equal to root of a square minus y square by a square minus x square. Root of a square minus y square by root of a square minus x square, which is the first option. Okay, then 15th question. If y is equal to log tan x to the base cot x into log cot x to the base tan x plus tan inverse of 4x by 4 minus x square, then dy by dx is equal to. Let us simplify this. I use change of base rule here. We have y is equal to log tan x to the base cot x. Tan x to the log tan x to the base cot x can be written as log tan x by log cot x into log cot x to the base tan x. Log cot x to the base tan x is log cot x divided by log tan x. Okay? Plus, I am using change of base rule. Tan inverse of, there I will 4x by 4 minus x square we have. I divide both the numerator and denominator by 4. When I divide by 4, we will have x by 1 minus x square by 4. I will write that as x by 2 whole square. And meanwhile, this x I will write it as 2 into x by 2. Okay. Here log cot x, log cot x, log tan x, log tan x. Everything gets cancelled. So y is equal to 1 plus, this is of the form tan inverse of 2x by 1 minus x square. We can write this as 2 tan inverse of x by 2. This is y. So y dash is equal to, differentiate this, 2 into derivative 1 is 0. 2 into derivative of tan inverse of x by 2 is 1 by 1 plus x square by 4 into the derivative x by 2. Derivative of x by 2 is 1 by 2. 2 to this cancel. That's equal to 4 plus x square by 4. This 4 will go up. So y dash is equal to 4 by 4 plus x square. Y dash is equal to 4 by 4 plus x square, which is the second option. Then 16th question. If y is equal to cot inverse of 1 plus x square minus x, then dy by dx is equal. Cot inverse x, you know cot inverse x can be written as tan inverse of 1 by x. So I will write the given expression as tan inverse of 1 by 1 plus x square minus x. Then given that y is cot inverse of 1 plus x square minus x, I am writing that as tan inverse of 1 by 1 plus x square minus x. Okay. Sorry. Tan inverse of 1 by 1 plus x square minus x, I will take x as common. So it will be x into x minus 1. Okay? On simplification, we get x square minus x. Now in the numerator, I will write this as x minus of x minus 1. Now if I simplify, I am going to get x minus x plus 1. X gets cancelled, 1 by 1 plus x square minus x. Okay. This is of the form y is equal to tan inverse of x minus y divided by 1 plus xy. Tan inverse of x minus y divided by 1 plus xy is equal to tan inverse x minus tan inverse y. So you get tan inverse x minus tan inverse of x minus 1. Now you differentiate this. Y dash is equal to derivative tan inverse x is 1 by 1 plus xy minus 1 by 1 plus x minus 1 whole square. So y dash is 1 by 1 plus x square minus 1 by 1 plus x minus 1 whole square, which is the third option. Then 17th question. If y is equal to 7 power log tan inverse of 2x by 1 minus x square to the base 7 plus e power log sin inverse x plus second inverse 1 by x, then dy by dx 7 power log. Here tan inverse of 2x by 1 minus x square, we can write that as 2 tan inverse x, 2 tan inverse x to the base 7 plus e to the power log sin inverse x plus cos inverse x. I will write that secant inverse 1 by x can be written as cos inverse x. Okay, 7 power log 2 tan inverse x to the base 7, a to the power log b to the base a to the power log b to the base a is equal to b. You know this formula. So I am using that formula. This will become 2 tan inverse x a power log b to the base a is equal to b plus what is sin inverse x plus cos inverse x, which is pi by 2. E power log f of x is equal to f of x. So this will be pi by 2. Now we differentiate this. Y dash is equal to 2 by 1 plus x square. Pi by 2 is constant, so it's derived is 0. So answer is 2 by 1 plus x square. That's the first option. Then 18th question. Dy by dx of sin inverse of 3 plus 4x divided by 5 into root of 1 plus x square. We'll call this expression as y as always. Y is equal to sin inverse of 3 plus 4x divided by 5 into root of 1 plus x square. I'll make a substitution. As soon as I see root 1 plus x square, the immediate substitution is put x equal to. Yes, what's the substitution? Yes, you're right. Put x equal to tan theta or cot theta. I go for tan theta. Put x equal to tan theta. Then that will imply that theta is equal to tan inverse x. Okay. So y equal to sin inverse of 3 plus 4 tan x, 4 tan theta, sorry, divided by 5 into This is 1 plus tan square theta, which is secant square theta. Root of that is secant. So I can write this as sine inverse of 3 by 5 cos theta plus 4 by 5 sine theta. Did you understand this step? I am splitting it into two terms. 3 by 5 secant theta, 3 by 5 secant theta plus 4 tan theta by 5 secant theta. Then secant theta, 3 by 5, here secant theta I took into numerator, it has become cos theta. Here 4 by 5, okay, tan theta by secant theta. I am writing tan theta as sin theta by cos theta and secant theta as 1 by cos theta. So cos theta gets cancelled, sin theta will be. Okay. Now, I will treat 3 by 5 as sin alpha. Like sin alpha is equal to 3 by 5. Then what about cos alpha? Cos alpha will be equal to 4 by 5. As you know, consider a right angle triangle here. Let this angle be alpha. I have taken sin alpha as 3 by 5. Opposite by hypotenuse. Then the adjacent side must be 4. So cos alpha is 4 by 5. Okay? So now you have y is equal to sin inverse of sin alpha cos theta plus cos alpha sin. This looks like sin A cos B plus cos A sin B. Sin A cos B plus cos A sin B is equal to sin A plus. Which means sin inverse of sin A plus B. Sin of alpha plus theta. Sin inverse of sin alpha plus theta is equal to alpha plus theta. What is alpha? Alpha I can write it as sin inverse of 3 by 5. And what is theta? Theta is nothing but tan inverse. Okay? So y is equal to sin inverse 3 by 5 plus tan inverse. Now differentiate this. Derivative of sin inverse 3 by 5 is 0. Derivative of tan inverse x is 1 by 1 plus x square, which is the first option. Okay? Then, let's solve one more problem. 20th question. D by dx of tan inverse of root of 2ax minus x square divided by a minus x. Okay. So, as always, we will call that expression as y. Y is equal to tan inverse of root of 2ax minus x square divided by a minus x. Now I will make a substitution as a minus x equal to a cos theta. Okay? That means x is equal to a into 1 plus cos theta. X is equal to a into 1 minus cos theta. Okay? I have taken a minus x equal to a cos theta. Then x is equal to a minus a cos theta. That means a into 1 minus cos theta. Okay. Let us substitute. Y is equal to tan inverse of root of 2a into this. That means 2a square into 1 minus cos theta. Minus x square. X square is a square into 1 minus cos theta whole square. Divided by a minus x is a cos theta. I will take a square as a common factor here. That when it comes outside the root, it will become a. That a, this a gets cancelled. So this is equal to tan inverse of root of, here I will simplify, a square we have taken out that. So this will be 2 minus 2 cos theta minus, expand this, 1 minus cos theta whole square. That will give you 1 plus cos square theta minus 2 cos theta. Multiply the minus sign there. So you get minus 1 minus cos square theta plus 2 cos theta. Divided by cos theta. Because a we have already mentioned. Okay. Now 2 cos theta, 2 cos theta gets cancelled. 2 minus 1 is 1, 1 minus cos square theta is sin square theta. Root of that is sin theta. Sin theta by cos theta is tan theta. So y is equal to tan inverse of tan theta. Okay, that's equal to theta. That is equal to, what is theta? From this I can write cos theta is equal to a minus x by a. So theta is equal to cos inverse of a minus x by a. Y is equal to cos inverse of a minus x by a. Okay, I will write here. Y is equal to cos inverse of a minus x divided by a. Now differentiate. Y dash is equal to minus 1 by root of 1 minus a minus x by a whole square into the derivative of a minus x by a, that is minus 1 by a. Here if I simplify, that's equal, minus and minus gets cancelled. 1 by root of a square minus a minus x whole square by a square, that I will take it outside the root, it will come a goes up a into 1 by minus into minus, already we have written as plus. A gets cancelled. Now expand this, a minus x whole square, that will give you a square plus x square minus 2ax. A square gets cancelled. So we have 1 by root of a square gets cancelled. That means what will remain? Okay, right. A square minus x square plus 2ax. Okay, a square gets cancelled. So they have 1 by root of 2ax minus x square. 1 by root of 2ax minus x square, which is the second option. That's the answer. Okay, students, with this I will stop today's class. Thank you. We'll continue.